Well, with the new year school starting at the University of Southern Maine, some neighbors in Gorham say they want to make sure parties at fraternity houses don't cause problems like they did last year. Residents and fraternity members have been meeting for months to work out their issues, and tonight they gathered in hopes of getting this year off to a positive note. News 8's Will Lewis just returned from the meeting. He joins us now with more new at 11. And good evening, Will.
Good evening, Tori. Some neighbors had hoped by the end of the meeting tonight there would be concrete guidelines for code of conduct by fraternity members. They didn't get their wishes, but they did get a promise that a code of conduct will be drafted. This is the third meeting between those living around fraternity houses on Preble Street. Members of three fraternities say they have been checking identification and trying to keep the crowds at their social events quiet. However, neighbors countered that there is still loud music being played at 3 in the morning, empty beer cans in their yards, and some property damage. Both sides have agreed to give the fraternities 2 weeks to draft a code of conduct for all members to follow.
I think it'll be more than reasonable, yes. You know, they're reasonable people, we're reasonable people, we are neighbors. I don't think there'll be a problem with reaching a consensus of what will be acceptable for both parties to be happy.
We have to define what we expect and what they're willing to give back. We were on Preble Street for 30 years, long before the fraternities even arrived. So we've experienced the quietness, the sanity. That has long gone.
Some in the crowd admitted that seven households may be ready to file a lawsuit if nothing is accomplished soon. Others feel that the university should take a more prominent role in solving the party problem. And if the university doesn't get involved, they hope the national office of each fraternity could do something. Both sides will meet again on September 16th to talk about the proposed code of conduct. In the newsroom, Will Lewis, News 8.